Hi guys, it's Steffi from the Novelty Corner. Welcome back to my channel and welcome to my Reading Rush TBR. Reading Rush is the readathon formerly known as the Booktubeathon. It is hosted by Ariel and Raylene and it is taking place from July 22nd until July 28th. There are 7 reading challenges throughout the week and I have picked 7 books to go along with them because... yeah, that's just what I do with my readathon TBRs. I will leave a link to the Reading Rush website as well as the announcement video. So if you need any more information, you can head on over there to check it out. The first challenge is to read a book with a purple cover. For that, I'm going to go with Viper by Bex Hogan. This is book 1 of Isles of Storm and Sorrow, I believe. This came in a fairy loot box. It was an advanced reading copy with an exclusive cover and it's very, very pretty. And there is a lot of purple on it. So I'm going to hopefully knock this one out during Reading Rush. Don't know what it's about. I'm assuming it's a fantasy book. We'll see when I read it. The second challenge is to choose a book and read it in the same spot the entire time. So whatever book you're reading, you have to read it in the same spot. So for me, that's pretty easy because I basically read all of my books on the couch. For this one, I have picked The Brightsiders by Jen Wilde. I think this one will be a pretty quick and easy read. I'll probably knock it out in a couple of hours sitting on the couch. This is a Love Osway contemporary book, and I think it is about someone who is in a band, but that is about the extent of my knowledge, except that I love Jen Wilde, I loved Queens of Geek, and I have been meaning to pick this up for ages. The third challenge is to read a book that you were supposed to read last year. For that, I'm going to go with The Extinction Trials by S.M. Wilson. This is on my Book Haul Revisited TBR for July and August anyway, so this is a good opportunity to throw it in here. Plus it is young adult and it should be a fairly quick and easy read. The next challenge is to read an author's debut novel. For that I'm going to try and read Nocturna by Maya Montaigne. This one is a fantasy book. This one came in my fairy loot box and okay, yeah, it's pretty big, so that's a bit ambitious for me to read in a readathon where there's read 7 books in 7 days, but I don't know, I'm gonna attempt it. Then you have to read a book with a non-human character. I struggle with this a little bit, but I'm going to go with The One and Only Ivan by Christine Applegate. This is a middle grade book, and I'm not entirely sure if Ivan is a main character in the book, but he's obviously a main feature of the book and he is not human. So I'm going to include this. The next challenge is to read a book that has 5 words in the title. The only book that I had on my TBR, or my physical TBR, was We Are Blood and Thunder by Kizia Lupo. I was sent this unsolicited for review way back at the start of the year and I haven't read it yet. I have heard some good things. It is a young adult fantasy book, but that is the extent of what I know. So this is going to be another mystery book on my TBR. Come on, we all know the drill now. I never know anything about my books before I go into them. The 7th and final reading challenge is to read a book and then watch its movie adaptation. And for this one, I don't actually have the book here. The book is in my classroom because I'm cheating just a little bit. And I'm going to read a picture book. And it's one of my favorite picture books, which I say all the time, but it is a favorite. And that is The Lost Thing by Sean Tan, because I have never actually watched the Lost Thing movie. So I'm going to reread the picture book and watch the movie. And I noticed that the movie comes with its own little guidebook. That is, what miscellaneous abnormality is that? And so technically I'm going to read 2 picture books to go with the movie. So does that count? My other option was going to be potentially to just reread one short story from Stories of Your Life and Others and read the titular Stories of Your Life and watch Arrival. But I think I might go with The Lost Thing because I haven't seen The Lost Thing and I'm planning on rewatching Arrival later in the year anyway. And if I read all of those books, then I also cover off on the challenge to read 7 books in 7 days. I have done that before. So it's a possibility. It might happen despite my giant fantasy books that are on this TBR. So that is my TBR for the Reading Rush. Let me know in the comments if you are participating in the Reading Rush and if you have a TBR video, I'd love to check it out. I hope that wherever you are in the world, you're having a wonderful day and I'll catch you guys in my next video. Thanks so much for watching. Bye guys.